Atchison High School, real quick before we get started, we do want to apologize. We had a few technical difficulties getting set up. But we are coming to you live from Atchison High School here in Atchison, Kansas. We have the Parsons Vikings taking on the Atchison Phoenix tonight in the sub-state championship game. Before we get into stats and all that stuff, I was able to convince Coach Battle for a sit-down interview, and I believe we do have that ready to go. So that'll cut, and then we'll roll. All right, so enjoy this interview. I appreciate Coach Battle for sitting down with me, and whenever that's good, we're ready to go. On Wednesday night.
Thank you. I appreciate it. I thought the kids did a great job. I thought they played well right from the get-go, and it was a real complete victory.
So talk to me a little bit about what did you think went really well, and then we're going to go back and we're going to talk about what needs a little bit of work.
Okay. Well, I felt, first of all, what went well last night, I thought we defended incredibly well. We did a great job communicating. They have a kid who's a really good player. He's going to sign at Butler to play college basketball. He averages 20 points a game, and we cut that in half. And it was a real group effort. I mean, a bunch of different guys had to guard him. I also felt that what was really key is that very early in the game, we were able to get some runouts because of the offense we generated from the defense, and we got in transition, and that was difficult for them to stop. And then I think the snowball just got rolling from there.
So I noticed they spent a lot of time outside the three-point line just moving the ball around. Was that by their design, or was that more of a symptom of the defense that you guys were playing?
Well, I think it was a little bit of both. I mean, most importantly, they wanted to have long possessions. Mm-hmm. So especially early, you saw that the game plan was clear that they were going to try to, I guess you could say, milk the clock.
Okay.
And our guys simply didn't let them by getting, you know, by tipping a basketball, by being in the right spot. You know, forcing turnovers and things like that. I felt it was a real benefit for us in the way we stayed patient on defense.
Okay. So what did you see on Wednesday that we needed, that you think needs improvement before Saturday?
Well, I'm really hoping that we shoot the ball from the perimeter a little bit better. You know, last couple games, it's been of a struggle. We've kind of been up and down with the way we're shooting behind the arc. We were combined 4 for 25 in the last two games from behind the three-point line. And so I'm hoping that's getting better. I'm very confident that our guys have the ability to be a good shooting team, and there's times where we've shot it really well. And, yeah, it would sure be nice for that to come our way on Saturday. So that's what I'm hoping for mainly.
Good, good. So I know it seems like in basketball we see the same teams a lot. We see, you know, we see our league schools twice a year, every single year, and you're on two-year contracts. So talk to me a little bit about your creating your game plan for a team that you don't see very young. You haven't seen Parsons. We haven't ever played Parsons, as to my knowledge. So talk about creating a game plan that for a team that we have never seen before.
Well, it's a two-dayer, and I've got a two-day prep, you know, to get the team ready. It's a pretty short turnaround, especially for a team that you haven't seen and our kids haven't seen them. We have not played them, you know, since I've been here for the past 4 years. So the process really has already begun. And, you know, I am doing some advanced scouting. You know, like I was telling the radio last week, I don't watch college basketball games on Saturday. I'm watching high school on YouTube.
Yeah.
And I spent a lot of hours doing that. So I've seen them on film already. It's tough because it's hard to gauge speed, and that's something we're just going to have to learn with and go with on the fly. But as far as a game plan, you know, what we'll be doing is today will be pretty much just kind of recovery day in practice. We'll work on the things that we need to work on, and then I'll hit the streets and get to busy with the game plan, and I'll have that done and ready by, you know, well, hopefully about midnight tonight, and then be able to throw that out on Friday and get us prepared. You know, what I see on film, though, with Parsons, there's a lot of things that will help us because they're a man-to-man defensive team. A lot of the sets that they run are things that we've seen before. You know, you really don't worry about team set plays. We worry about actions within the play. They do a lot of ball screening, a lot of staggered ball screening. So, you know, we're going to come out and combat with what we use for those situations, which we've been working on every day since November. So it's about just getting those parts and those pieces and understanding where they're looking to score. And it's always a defense-first game plan.
Defense first. So real quick before we move on, I noticed on Wednesday that we are fast when we have the ball on offense. We move quickly, and it seems like we score really fast. Is that a design of the offense that we run, or is that more of a symptom of the kids that we have? They just go quick.
Oh, I'll say circle C for all the above. I think it's both our kids and their abilities and the things that we do in practice on a daily basis. You know, one of the first drills we do is a full court passing drill for layups. So it's something they do every single day. They love to do it. So I think part of it has been conditioned, but I think also part of it's credit to our guys. And of all the teams that I've had, this is perhaps one of the best teams that's sharing the basketball. And so it makes you go faster. You know, it's, you know, the best way from here to there is through the air, an old football coach once told me.
Yeah. So back to Wednesday, who stepped up when it mattered most on Wednesday? You said you stepped back from the game and you watched a little film. You're like, wow, that they really stepped up.
I felt it was a collective effort. You know, I felt that there was some adversity. We got into foul trouble early. You know, Trey was the guy that we were going to, you know, play stick defense on, the really good player for El Dorado, and he got two quick ones. Then we had to bump it to Zamar, and then Zamar got into a little bit of foul trouble, and then Jay-Z stepping up and giving us everything that he had. I felt that Jeter was consistent all night long, and you can't say enough about what Eric did on the boards and attacking the glass. So I can't really identify one individual. I felt it was a real collective effort, which is what makes it a lot of fun to watch.
Yeah, it was a fun game to watch. All right, last question before we get out of here. Give me your first impressions of Parsons and, you know, things, keys to the game for the Phoenix.
Okay.
On Saturday night.
Well, first and foremost, if anyone's planning to come to the game, it is going to be up and down, and it's going to be fast. It's really going to be a fast game. They like to play fast. We like to play fast. So it's strength versus strength. I think the real key is going to be for us not only getting out and running, but also recovering and getting back and limiting them to get easy baskets. I think it's going to be a game that's ultimately going to be won by who gets the most easy baskets in transition. I mean, it's really got the looks of that kind of game. They play pretty fast. They got a really nice post player inside who they can go to. They got a couple shooters on the edges as well, and some kids who can get downhill. I mean, they, in a lot of ways, I see a lot of us in them.
Yeah.
You know, so I think it's strength on strength, and I think it's going to be whoever executes the best and gets back and defends.
So when they have common opponents, do you look at their film? So I noticed today, I was looking at, they played Altamont Labette County, and we did also.
Yeah.
Do you look at their film against Altamont, and then you go back and watch our film against Altamont and kind of see?
Well, I'll be honest with you. I think that every game is its own entity, and every matchup is its own variation and matchup. Altamont is a very different team than Parsons is in terms of how they're built, how they're wrapped, how they play. It's a completely different game. You know, that Labette County came out and wanted to, of course, zone us. It was their first thing that they were going to do, and we were able to hit a few threes. We were able to get in transition and knock them out of that. So the game totally changes. Mm-hmm. So it's really hard to do comparison stuff.
Okay.
I really try to look at how I see them matching up against us.
Okay. That's good. I'm happy that we're here once again, and I feel like this team is so fun to watch, and I hope, it seems like you're having fun coaching them, and just as a whole, this team is just, seems like they really have a lot of drive. And we talked a little bit about that on Tuesday. So, you know, you said, once again, let's talk about the seniors one more time. Just
sure.
The senior leadership on your team.
Well, I think that what's really fun is since they were my first freshman class, mm-hmm. they're also now my first graduating class.
Yeah.
You know, that have gone through and only known Atchison basketball
under
Coach Battle.
Yeah.
And I can't say enough about their leadership and their communication, their willingness to make changes on the fly, their adaptability, and just to have seen their growth over the last 4 years has been a lot of fun. And I'm just so very proud of all four of them, you know, and what they've done. And it's going to be sad to see, you know, I want to keep playing because I don't want that to end.
No,
I really don't. No.
Absolutely. All right. This will be the final last question. I promise. We've only had three last questions.
No problem.
The importance of playing a game like this at home where you don't have to travel 3.5 hours to get to Parsons.
I, You know, sometimes it seems like a huge advantage. I think having a big crowd will be a great advantage for us. But then also, I've been in situations where you are on the road going away, and you kind of get that us against the world type of mentality, mm-hmm. and it brings out a little bit more in your guys than what mm-hmm. you thought you had. Mm-hmm. So we've got to be prepared to battle against that.
Yeah.
But nonetheless, yes, I think being at home, the community's very excited, the kids are very excited, and I think that is a plus and an advantage for us. It certainly felt like that last year against Hayden.
Good. So what you're saying is if you're watching this on Saturday evening, because this is when it's going to air, Saturday evening, you need to turn us off and you need to get to the game.
Absolutely.
All right.
Absolutely.
Well, Coach, I appreciate your time. Thank you very much for stopping
by. Thanks a
lot.
I appreciate the coverage.
Yeah. Anytime. I want to give a huge shout out to Coach Battle for doing that. We're going to talk a little history here. I'm a history teacher here at the high school, and I love to talk history. So we're going to flash up some graphics here, and we're going to go through these. So when we're talking about history, Atchison has a very rich history in basketball. We have five state titles here at the high school that, you know, belong to Atchison High School. 1969, 1976, 1985, 1986, and 1988. There in the 80s, Atchison High, they were rolling under Chick Downing. They were just rolling, and you want to get back to that. In addition to that, we have multiple appearances in the state title game. You know, this includes all the state titles we won, but it also includes the ones we may not have won. 69, 76, 79, 83, 85, 86, and 87. The, you know, good teams that just maybe fell short, maybe something happened, you know, these were still really good basketball teams. And then you have your Final Four appearances, you know, the years that perhaps didn't win at all, didn't get to the state title game necessarily, but we're in the top four. 19, 16, 17, 59, 69, 70, 75, 76, 79, there's more here, 83, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 04, and 06. 04 and 06. I mean, those relatively recent Final Fours, but, I mean, you're still looking at almost 20 years ago. Almost 20 years. And then, finally, tournament appearances. Guys, there's a ton of these. There's, I think, 3 pages of these. So, you've got 19, 16, 17, 19, 24, 26, 33, 59, 67, 69, 70, 75, 76, 77, 79, 83, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 02, 04, 06, 07, 15, and 23. So we're looking to get back 2 years in a row here. And it's been a very long time since we've gone to the state tournament 2 years in a row as a school. And this, like Coach Battle said in his interview, the senior leadership on this team is just phenomenal, and you want that for these guys. You know, I have a number of these seniors in class, and they are just phenomenal students. They're phenomenal people, and you want that for them. You want them to succeed, and you want them to have all the success in the world. So looking at Parsons a little bit, and we're going to run short on time here, but we're going to run through this pretty quick. Looking at Parsons here, I don't have any stats for Parsons. I couldn't find any. I guess I got lucky with El Dorado on Wednesday where they had all of their stats on Max Preps. Parsons, I can't find anything. So looking at Parsons, they're coming into us, and I'm going to pull it up here so I have it. They're coming in here. They're bringing a 9-11 record, now it's 10-11 record, into Atchison. Okay, losses, they place it in Southeast Kansas. Okay, their losses: Girard, Towanda Circle, Mulvane, Fort Scott, Riverton, Chanute, Pittsburgh, Fort Scott again, Pittsburgh again, Coffeyville, and Independence. These are good teams. There's a lot of good basketball that's played in Southeast Kansas. Atchison comes in with a 19-2 record, ranked second in the state by the Kansas Basketball Coaches Association. Their only 2 losses on the year are to number 3 ranked Topeka Highland Park, and Topeka Highland Park qualified for the 5A state tournament yesterday. So they're going to be playing in Emporia next week. Those Highland Park's a good basketball team, and you know, Atchison plays 5 and 6A schools, big 4As, 5 and 6A schools, and in the league that we play in, that Kansas City, Kansas School District, they're big schools. So looking at this, you know, Parsons plays bigger schools as well. Pittsburgh's a 5A. Okay. So looking at this, you know, one common opponent this year is Altamont Labatt County. Both teams beat Altamont this when they played. Parsons beat them twice. Atchison, of course, only played them once, and we beat them. So it looks like we're going to be getting ready. We're about a minute away from tip-off here. We're going to be having introductions, as you can see. Real quick, give a huge shout-out to our cheerleaders, and I'll talk about them later. But Brittany Schultz is their coach. Does a phenomenal job. We do want to thank all of our administration here at the high school. We want to thank Mrs. Letitia Williams, our principal. We want to thank Mr. Blaine Clarity, our assistant principal, Mr. Tyler Lukanoff, our athletic director. All of three of those individuals are in their first year here, and they have done an amazing job coming in and just diving in and trying to get what the teachers need and get these kids what they need and try and have some fun. I was just told that we're getting ready to go to the court. And so you'll probably see me coming out of halftime, maybe in between quarters. We'll see how it all plays out, but you'll see the court next shot. Here we go. Looks like we are going to be getting ready for the national anthem. We're going to be hitting the national anthem, and then from there we will be ready to go. So I'll be quiet while the national anthem is playing.
We honor the United States of America with the playing of our national anthem.
All right, we are ready to go through the starters for both teams. I am just going to run through the Parsons starters. Parsons comes in averaging 53.6 points per game. Like I said, they have a 10-11 record, 53.6 points per game. All right, their starters are going to be, real quick before I get going on their starters, their head coach, Anthony Hoke. Assistant coaches are Wes Curl, Christy Snyder, and Greg Lampikins. Okay. All right, starters for Parsons, we have number one, Jamario Kendrick, 6'1" senior. Number two, Trayvon Mack, 5'9" senior. We're going to have number four, 5'10" junior, Dante Sawyer. Number five, 6'4" senior, Landon Wheat. And number 21, 6'1" senior, Tavion Tullis. Your starters for the Phoenix, okay? Your starters for the Phoenix. Doesn't look like they're being introduced on the court. We'll wait. I can talk a little bit more about stats while we wait for the starters to finish being introduced for Parsons. Points per game-wise, nothing's really changed since Wednesday. Jeter's averaging 17.5. Zamar comes in averaging 15.4. Eric, 12.4. Trey Carter, 8.3. Jay-Z, 6.8. Jace, 3.6. And Yogi, 3.6. Yogi was very proud of himself because he did score more points this year on Wednesday. So he actually called my classroom when I had Jeter and pointed that out. All right, looks like Parsons just got finished being introduced. Now we're going to introduce the lineup for your Atchison Phoenix. Getting ready to come out here. All right, first up, we have number zero, Zamar Hernandez, a 5'10" senior.
Number two, Jeter Purdy, 6'4" senior. Number three, senior Trey Carter, stands at 5'9". Josiah Kelly, junior. We'll call him JC tonight. And finally, number 23, standing at 6'3", a junior, Eric Smith III. All right, we are getting ready to get underway here. 8 minutes is on the clock. Four quarters stand between Atchison and another state tournament appearance. Okay? That's all we got here. This is it. This is for all the Petunias. This is what they've been working for since mid-November. You know, these. One thing we need to point out to you is these guys haven't really had a break. You know, because the way it works in Kansas, when the football, depending on how far you go in football, it depends on how much break you get in between your winter and sports season. So, because we went to the sectional round in football, these guys started, you know, and all of five starters started football for us. And so these guys went right in. There was no break. I think Coach Battle gave them, I think, a week. But, they, you know, Coach Battle was practicing, the JV and the guys who didn't play football. All right, so Jeter comes to the center for the tip. Tip goes to Parsons, and they're going to have the first possession here. All right, taking that as number two, Trayvon Mack. All right, he's going to set up that offense. Going to work outside the three-point line. Getting it down low there, guarded by Eric Smith. Back up top to the three-point, at the top of the three-point line. Going to move around, try and make something happen. Doesn't like what he sees, gets it back outside the three-point line. Coach Battle did say this was going to be a high-scoring, very quick game. So, shot up, no good. Rebounded by Eric Smith. That was actually blocked. And Trey's got it. He gets it to Jeter. Jeter's going to take a three-point shot right off the bat. Going to go off the rim. Rebounded by Parsons, but it went off the top of the backboard. So that means it is out of bounds. Parsons going to take it out here. Looks like Atchison's going to play a little bit of a full-court press. Try and put the pressure on Parsons early and force them into something that maybe they don't like. Jay-Z playing defense there at the top. Round drives to the basket. Shot up. No good. Rebounded by Trey Carter. Trey Carter got it to Eric Smith. Eric Smith going to the basket. Oh, and he jams it home. The first 2 points. Oh, are they going to give Eric? Oh, they're going to give him. Man. Wow. They're going to go ahead, and I think, yeah, they're going to give Eric a technical foul for hanging on the rim there. So that is going to be Eric's first technical foul of the night. So two free throws for Parsons are upcoming here. So Atchison currently leads 2-1. 2-1, 7:04 to go, less than a minute into this game in the first quarter. Second free throw up and good. All right, and this is what Coach Battle was talking about, you know, doing the little things right. You know, you get that energy. That's not really what you want to see, because you get that energy going from that dunk, and then you got to give the ball right back, and they get their free throws. So that kind of stops your momentum, and it stops the good things that were happening. All right, Parsons ball now. They're down low. Back up top outside the three-point line. Trey's got it. He's going to try and poke his hand in there. Couldn't quite get it. Nice screen there. Down low. Shot up. Going to call a foul, but the shot was no good. They're going to shoot two free throws. All right, that is going to be Eric's second foul. He is in some quick foul trouble tonight. That's not what you want to see this early in the game. All right, first free throw for the Parsons is up, and it is good. That shooting free throws is Jamario Kendrick, okay? And Erickson come out of the game with those two fouls. In comes Yogi Purdy, averaging 3.6 points per game for the Phoenix. Second free throw incoming, up, good. All right, so we're at Parsons 4, Atchison 2. Atchison back quickly on offense. Very quickly on offense for the Phoenix. That's Zamar, out to Trey. Trey's going to take a three-point shot. And that was too long. Parsons with the rebound, and they're right back down the court. Moving fast here. Atchison with an early two-point deficit. Trying to get the defense working. Long two, no good. Rebounded by Yogi Purdy. He's got it over to Trey Carter. Trey taking it up the court here. Going to go quick. Over to Jeter. Jeter thought about a three, decided against it. Drives to the basket, lost the handle. Picked up by the Parsons Vikings. Parsons going to drive to the basket. Layup up. Good. Quick 4 points down for Atchison. 6-2 is your score here in favor of the Parsons Vikings. Atchison back on offense. Zamar Hernandez with the ball, trying to set up the offense, figure out a way to break this Parsons defense early. Zamar gets it over to Yogi. Yogi right back. No, he's got it. Good move there. But over to Trey. Trey going to take a three. He's thinking about it. Decided against it. Gets it over to Jeter. Good handle by Jeter Purdy. Gets it over to Jay-Z. Jay-Z to Zamar. Jay-Z, or Zamar thought about a three. Gets it over to Yogi. He's going to take a shot. Oh, no good. So close. Rebounded by the Parsons Vikings, though. All right, 6-2 is your score here. 5.5 to go in the first quarter. Parsons, long three shot. No good. Rebound, Trey Carter. Trey's got it. Over to Jeter. Jeter over to Jay-Z. Ooh, Jay-Z about lost the handle on that. Good defense. Down low to Yogi. Good handle by Yogi. Yogi immediately over to Jeter. Ball's on the ground, and that's a turnover, and that is going to be Parsons' ball. Yogi does hit the deck there, and they're going to have a shot in. All right. 8-2 for Parsons. All right. That's going to be our first timeout. Coach Battle took his first timeout there, I have to imagine. This is exactly the start that Parsons wanted, and this is exactly the start that you didn't want for the Atchison Phoenix. So Coach Battle's going to take his first time out. Let's thank our sponsors real quick for all that they do to support us here at Atchison High School. We're going to thank Daylight Donuts, and then we're going to thank Cornerstone Printing for these two sponsor our broadcast and live stream. Sadie Stone down there at Cornerstone does a great job. Daylight Donuts, great place to go get donuts. Me and my wife actually went and got donuts this morning. Delicious. So we're very fortunate to have those two great sponsors here in town that are going to support us. So coming out of this timeout here, Coach Battle just wants his guys to regroup a little bit. This is going to be Phoenix ball. Okay, Phoenix ball. So five on the floor for the Phoenix. You have the starting five with the exception of Eric, and he's been subbed out for Yogi. So you've got Jay-Z, Zamar, Trey, Jeter, and Yogi. All right, Parsons has made no substitutions. They still have their five in. All right, that was Trey to Jay-Z. Jay-Z's got it. He gets it out to Jeter. Jeter over to Trey. Trey's going to take a three. No good. Rebound, Jay-Z Kelly. Jay-Z's got it. Zamar's got a three. No good. Rebound, Yogi Purdy. Put back. No good. We're going to have a foul. We are going to have a foul called. All right, that is going to be Yogi Purdy going to the line. Yogi Purdy on the year is shooting 55.6% from the free throw line. All right, that is number four. That is Dante Sawyer, and that is his first foul of the night. Yogi Purdy at the free throw line. Phoenix down six. Yogi's first free throw up and good. Cut the deficit to five. Yogi's going to try and cut it to four here. Second free throw for Yogi is up. In and out. No good. Parsons got it. No, Zamar's got it. He gets it over to Yogi. Yogi's going to lay it in. Good. All right. Phoenix now only down by one. Parsons with the ball. I'm sorry, that basket did not count. Jeter's got it. He's going to lay it in. No good. Rebound Parsons. Parsons got it. Taking it up the court. 5-8 is your score. Phoenix down by three. Long three for the Vikings. No good. Rebound Jeter Purdy. Jeter's got it. Over to Trey. Parsons trying to apply a little pressure down low there, but they get back quickly. They know the Phoenix like to go quick. Oh, man. Trey's pass to Yogi. Just couldn't quite get a handle on it. But it did go out of bounds on the Vikings. So, Phoenix down three. Trey standing at the baseline, getting ready to inbounds this ball. Trying to find somebody open, gets it over to Jeter Purdy. Gets it over to Zamar. Zamar's got it, he's gonna drive. Oh, he's tripped up, loses the ball. Yogi's got it, shot blocked by the Vikings. Vikings back quickly on offense, trying to extend this lead. Long three, thought about it, decided against it. About got tripped up there, no shot, driving down. Long three, up, no good. Rebound Jeter Purdy. Jeter's got it. He gets it over to Trey. Over to Zamar, way down the court. Zamar's going to drive, no good. All right, Parsons looks like they got somebody ready to check in here. All right, that is foul on number two, Trayvon Mack. That is his first of the night. Trey standing at the baseline. 5-8 is your score. Two team fouls each. All right, Trey gets it out to Jay-Z. Jay-Z's going to take a three. No good. Rebound, Parsons. Parsons going to go quickly back on offense. Long pass down the court. Back outside. Jeter on defense there. Lots of outside the three-point line. Parsons seems like they like to shoot the three. Phoenix down three. 3:07 to go in this first quarter. 3:07 to go in this first quarter. Less than three to go. Oh, Trey almost had that picked off there. Three-point shot up for the Vikings. Up, and it is good. All right, Phoenix going to get back on O quickly here. Long pass down the court for Trey. He gets it to Zamar. Zamar's going to lay it in. No good. Rebound, Vikings. Vikings back on offense. All right, 11-5 is your score. Timeout here. We're gonna have another timeout. All right, down six. Phoenix down six. However, we saw on Wednesday, and we've seen throughout the year, how quickly things can shift in a basketball game. You know, basketball is much different than football. Down by six in football could be a world. Down by six in basketball, that's not much. If the Phoenix can get a couple stops, get a couple big shots going. So far, they have not had much success shooting three-point ball. You've got to imagine that Coach Battle wants them to get that three-point ball going, but at the same time, not waste possessions. Okay, you don't want to waste possessions. You don't want to do all that work and get nothing out of it. All right, so Jace Richards has checked into the game for Yogi, number 31, Jace Richards. He is a 6'5" junior. Jace adds a lot of length to this team. All right, Parsons inbounds. All right, Jay-Z on defense there. Quick offense here by Parsons. Going to take, thought about a three, decided against it. Down low, going to drive, shot up. Good for the Vikings. All right, 13-5 is your score. Phoenix now down eight. Trey Carter taking it up the floor. Screen there by Jace for Trey. Trey's going to, we're going to have a foul call here. I see the official trotting to the table. Looks like Trey is going to be shooting 1-1 free throws here. Is that going to be shooting free throws? We'll see. All right, third foul on the night for Parsons. Number 21, that is Tavian Tullis. That is his first of the night. No free throws. Inbounds, Jay-Z's got it. He's going to lay in two. Nice, easy layup there to get the momentum back on our side. Oh, loose ball. Zamar's got it. Shot up. Good. Rebounded by the Vikings. All right, here we go. Trey's, looks like the Phoenix is going to get another inbounds. They're going to be able to maintain possession. There was a foul going to be called on Parsons. No. That's going to be a foul on Zamar, and that is his first of the night. So Parsons with the ball. You want to be able to capitalize when the ball is rolling around on the ground. All right, Parsons on offense. Trey about got that out. Nice block there by Jace Richards. Trey's got it, taking it up over to Jay-Z. Jay-Z's got it. Two more for the Phoenix. Here we go. We are now, you're starting to see the speed. You're starting to see the speed of this game that Coach was talking about. Down low, double team down there. Get it back outside. Oh, all right. Traveling call on Parsons. So Phoenix ball here. See Jace going down there. He's going to inbounds the ball here to Trey Carter. All right, Jace to Trey. Trey's going to take it up the court. 13-9 is your score. Phoenix down four. Phoenix down four. Trey's got it, tries to make a move. Gets it out to, it looks like Jay-Z. Long pass over to Jace. Jace has it. He's going to take it down low. Put it up, shot. No good. All right, there is going to be a foul. Looks like Parsons is clapping. So something good happened for the Vikings, I see. All right, Parsons has the ball here, going to inbounds. Phoenix trying to add to just put a little pressure on them. You know, they're not super tight on this full court press, but you have to imagine that at some point this is going to tighten up. Parsons with the ball outside three-point line. Trey poked that out. He's got it, taking it quickly. He's going to put up a jump shot, and it's good.
All right, Phoenix have cut this deficit to two. Less than a minute to go in the first quarter now. Good basketball move there by the Vikings. All right. Offense now working for the Vikings. Defense going. All right, we're going to have another foul call. It looks like that one's going to be on Zamar. Yep, that is going to be Zamar's second of the night. So Phoenix in a little foul trouble. This early going here. Phoenix going into a little foul trouble here. Both Zamar and Eric with two each. Okay, remember, folks, you only get five. All right, 30 seconds to go in the first quarter. Parsons up 13-11. Lead is two. All right, Trey Carter on defense. Gonna drive, kick it back outside the three-point line. That is number 22, Joseph Keel. He's got the ball now. Parsons seems like they're trying to slow it down here before the end of the first quarter. They obviously do not want the Phoenix to score again. 3 seconds. They're going to take the last shot here. Long three up. No good. Rebound. Doesn't matter. That is the end of the first quarter here. All right. End of one. End of one. Here in Atchison, you've got Parsons. Parsons visiting Parsons Vikings, 13. Atchison Phoenix, 11. All right, real quick, as you see our cheerleaders come out, let's thank our sponsors one more time. We're going to thank Cornerstone Printing and Daylight Donuts for all they do for sponsoring our broadcasts and live streams. And as we're moving through this, you know, you have to think that at some point, Coach Battle may want to turn up the heat a little bit on Parsons and try maybe a full court press. I know that that's exhausting and it wears you guys out. You know, we'll see. We'll see what they do in this second quarter. Obviously, you want the second quarter to go better than the first, okay? But that start by the Vikings is about as good as they could have asked for. It's probably all they could have asked for out of the first quarter. All right, so as you see, huddle breaks. Cheerleaders going back to the baselines. Student section stands up. We're ready to get this second quarter underway. All right, so Vikings ball. I'm sorry, that's going to be the Atchison ball because they had the first possession here. All right, Trey's got it. He gets it over to Jeter. Back to Trey. Trey puts up a shot. No good. Rebound Vikings. Vikings back on offense. Vikings back on offense here. Phoenix trying to play a little bit of defense, trying to lock them down. Don't want them to score any more points. Zamar tried to poke that out here. So, we got the starting five back out for the Phoenix. That is Eric, Zamar, Jeter, Jay-Z, and Trey. Going to drive to the basket, decided against it. Going to kick it outside. Going to drive again. Going to trap him. Around behind, gonna drive, shot up, no good. Rebound, Jay-Z Kelly. He's got it. He gets it over to Trey, and off and running we go. Zamar's got it. Oh, he about lost the handle on that, but he was able to get it. Oh, long pass to Eric. That was high, but Eric's long arm got it. 2 points up and good. No, they're gonna not count that. They're gonna wave that one off. Not gonna let that one go. All right, that is another foul on number 21. Tavion Tullis, that is his second of the night. Phoenix ball, no good. Jeter shot up, no good. You saw the Viking there slam that ball against the backboard. Trey's asking for a technical violation on him. But Jeter is going to go to the line here. On the year for Jeter, 70.1 free throw percentage shooter. All right, that is Tavion Tullis. That is his third of the night. So, starting to see one Parsons player get into a little foul trouble. First free throw for Jeter is going to be up. No good. 11-13 is your score here. 6:54 to go in the second quarter or the first half. Jeter's second free throw upcoming here. Second free throw is up. Good. All right. Phoenix now only down by one. Phoenix now only down by one. Parsons off and running here. Working outside the three-point line. Looks like Atchison's trying to play a little bit of a man defense here. Down low, no good.
Rebound, Parsons, reshot, no good, and that, but that one does go in. And they're going to wave that one off and let the Vikings shoot free throws. So at the line for the Vikings is number four, Dante Sawyer. That is the first foul of the quarter on the Phoenix. And that is going to be Eric Smith. That is his third foul of the night. So out comes Eric, in comes Yogi with that third foul. All right. Oh, they did count that. So it's 15 to 12 now. Parsons trying to extend this lead here. They're going to probably shoot one. First one up. Good. Atchison going on offense. Here we go. 16 to 12. Phoenix down by four. 6.5 to go in the second quarter. Trey setting up the offense here. Kind of barking orders, trying to get the offense going. Down to Zamar. Zamar's going to make a move. Put up a shot, and that one's going to go. Get the easy ones going. 16-14, your score now. Phoenix down by two. Parsons back on offense. Trying to slow him down. Long three, no good. Rebound. Jay-Z Kelly, he's got it. That was a great rebound. He's extended way up for that. All right, Trey's got it. He gets it over to Zamar. Zamar down to Yogi. Yogi's going to turn, put up a shot. No good. Yogi hit the deck. Yogi hit the deck there. Over to the official, runs over to the table. Going to call a foul. That is number four, Dante Sawyer, and that is his second of the night. Yogi Purdy going to the line on the year. Yogi shoots 55.6% from the free throw line. All right, 14-16, your score. All right, here we go. Looks like Yogi's going to get two free throws. First free throw is up. Good. Second free throw upcoming here. This is to tie the game. And we're going to be all knotted up in the sub-state championship game. All right, out comes Jay-Z, in comes Jace. Wants a little bit of length down there. Second free throw is up. No good, off the front of the rim, rebound Parsons. All right, Phoenix down by one. Parsons back on offense. Going quick, thought about a three, decided against it. Traveling on the Vikings. So that's going to be, the ball's going to go right back to the Phoenix with a chance to take the lead. Take the lead for the first time since the first basket was scored for the Phoenix. That's going to feel good if they can get a basket here. All right, long pass over to Jeter. Jeter had to go way up for that. Back right back to Trey. Trey's got it. Over to Zamar. Back to Trey. Trey to Yogi. Yogi to Trey. Trey to Zamar. Zamar's going to take a three. Up, no good. Rebound Vikings. Vikings going fast. Back on offense, trying to get an advantage. Going to put in a layup. No good. Blocked by Trey Carter. He's got the ball. He gets it to Jeter. Jeter's going to go quick. Jace is down there holding up his hand. I've got it. Lost ball, but Zamar ended up back with it. All right, Zamar's got the ball. He's going to shoot a long pass over to Jace. Jace back to Zamar. Zamar's going to take another three. Up, good! Phoenix with their first lead since early in the first quarter. 18-16 is the score here. Parsons back on offense. Good defense by the Phoenix, and we're going to have a foul. We're going to have a foul called. Who's that going to be on? We'll find out here in just a second. Looks like Parsons is going to go to the baseline. That's going to be Jace Richards. That is his first of the night. All right. Yep. Baseline inbounds play here for the Vikings. Long pass, almost past half court. Okay. Long three for the Vikings. No good. That one was way long. Jeter gets the rebound there. He's going to get it. Oh, what have we got here? We got clapping. There's clapping. All right, 22 foul for Parsons. And that is Joseph Keel. And that is his first of the night. All right, so that's going to be a timeout by Parsons. Parsons calls a timeout here. I'm assuming that's Parsons. All right, so coming off of this timeout here, you're going to see Parsons taking you're going to see that Parsons is going to have an opportunity to, or I'm sorry, not Parsons, the Phoenix are going to have an opportunity to extend this lead with 4:39 to go in the second quarter here. 4:39 to go in the second quarter, okay? You want to see, you really want to see Atchison take control, okay? This is the time when the Phoenix need to take control. They've been tested all year long playing, you know, these phenomenal teams that they play in the KC or the Metal Arc Conference, okay? You want to see them take control, and you want to see them hold on to control in this game. All right, as you see, we're breaking here. All right, they're down in the Parsons half of the court. You're going to see Jeter and Trey. You're going to see Jeter and Trey down there. Jeter inbounds into Trey. Trey's got it. He's going to take it up court. All right, Trey's calling out signals, telling him what play he wants him to run. Quarterback of the basketball team. DeMar's got it, going to drive, lay it in. Good! Two more for the Phoenix. Phoenix now lead by four. Less than 4.5 to go in the second quarter. Parsons back on offense. Here we go. Coach Battle's over there saying, get your arms up. Let's play some defense now. He said in his interview he wanted a defensive first. Shot blocked. Oh, they're going to call a foul on that. No, they're not. No foul. That was just out of bounds off of Jace. That was a great block that Jace Richards just had. All right, Parsons to inbounds. Atchison up by four. 20-16 is the score. 4:10 to go. 4:12 to go. Now it's 4:10. All right, here we go. Parsons on offense. Trying to play a little defense here. 20-16. Trey on defense there at the top of the line. Lost it. Jace got it. Gets it over to Trey. Trey's going to run. He's going to get it over to Jace. Jace going to put up a shot. Good! Two more points for the Phoenix. 22-16. 22-16. Here we go. Parsons back on offense. This is what we were expecting, this quick of a game. Pass tip picked off by Zamar. Zamar's going to take it up the court. He's going to go quick here. He's going to drive to the basket. Oh, he lost control there. Ball rolls. Parsons got it. Back on offense in a hurry. Phoenix back on defense very quickly. Shot up. No good. Ball's on the ground. Who's got it? Parsons has it. What's going to happen? We have a whistle. Looks like Yogi got whacked in the head there. All right. Let's see what happens here. Okay. Who's going to have the ball here? You see the official talking to Coach Battle. I wonder what he's saying. Okay. 3:20 to go in the second quarter. 22-16 in favor of the Phoenix. Okay. Jay-Z has checked into the game. Zamar is checking out. Get him a little breather. Okay. Trey calling, telling everybody what's going to happen here. Parsons going to inbounds. Yep, Parsons going to inbounds the ball. So it will be Parsons' ball here, 22-16. And after the first half of that first quarter, the Phoenix have to be happy with the way the rest of this quarter has kind of gone, the rest of this half is gone. Obviously not where you want it to be at this point, but still, to have a lead after going down by that many is impressive. All right. Ball was loose there. Phoenix ball here. Excellent. All right, Jay-Z to inbounds it to Trey. Trey's got it. Gonna go quick. Coming up on the 3-minute mark in the second quarter. Yogi's got it, thought about a three. He's gonna drive, shot up, no good. They're gonna call a foul. Yes, gonna be a foul on the Vikings. 22-16, Yogi with a chance to extend this lead a little bit. That is number three. That is number three, Jaeger Quirin. He is a sophomore, and that is his first foul of the night. All right, Yogi's free throw upcoming here. Free throw up. Good. All right. So on the floor for the Phoenix, you have Jace Richards, Jay-Z Kelly, Jeter Purdy, Trey Carter, and Yogi Purdy. Jace out there playing defense on the three-point line. Long three for the Vikings. Up off the back of the rim. Rebound. Oh, Yogi almost had it. Quick shot up for the Vikings. No good. Rebounded Jay-Z. Jay-Z gets it to Trey. Trey's going to move up the court here. Trying to extend this lead even further. Coming up on 2.5 to go in the first half. of the sub-state championship game. This is to go to the state tournament in Salina being held next week. Trey's going to drive. Loses it. Lost the handle on that. Vikings got it. Back on offense with the Vikings. Okay. Vikings down seven. 3-point shot up. No good. Rebound. Jace. He's got it. He gets it over to Jeter. Jeter's going to run down the court here. Going to probably get it back to Trey to set up the offense. Trey's got it. Where's he going to go with it? He gets it over to Jay-Z. Jay-Z says, come over closer. Come closer. Down to Jace. Jace puts it up. Good! 25-16 is now the score. Phoenix lead by nine. Less than two to go in the first half. Long three up for Parsons. Good. That was fast. Here we go. Jeter inbounds to Trey. Trey's got it. He's going to take it up. Minute 37 to go in the first half. Jay-Z's got it. Jay-Z behind the back dribble. About lost it, but he maintained control. Looks like he got tangled up there. Gets it to Yogi. Yogi's got it. What's Yogi going to do? He's going to get it over to Trey. Trey's got it. Oh, Trey lost the handle on that. Looks like Trey is going to go to the line for some free throws. Okay, so that is number four. Okay, that is Dante Sawyer, and that is his third of the night. So Parsons now has two with three fouls. Okay, on the year, Trey Carter shoots 60.5% from the free throw line. He's got two here coming up. Chance to extend this lead. Let's see, first free throw up. Good. All right. Second free throw up coming here. 26-19 is the score. 1:20 to go in the first half. Second free throw up. Good. Trey goes 2 for 2 on those. That's exactly what we needed. All right. Phoenix now back up by eight. Up by eight. 27-19 is the score. Parsons on offense. They get the ball inbounds. Looks like, once again, they're trying to play a little bit of that, I want to call it a soft full court press, just to put that pressure on Parsons as they're trying to inbounds. Nothing easy. Don't want to give them too much that's easy. Ball is out. That's going to be last touch by the Phoenix. Parsons will maintain possession. Okay. Clock sits at 107. You got to imagine that, you know, Phoenix won at least a couple of more baskets here before the end of the quarter. All right. Parsons long pass inbounds. Trey got a hand on that. Going to go right out of bounds. Okay. Knocked it out. Real quick, I didn't do this at the top. The Phoenix are coached by head coach Pat Battle, assisted by coach Mark May and Christian Arnold. All right, Parsons on offense. Parsons on offense. Probably looking for a three here. We'll see, though. Less than a minute to go. Less than a minute to go. Parsons trying to work, trying to set something up that they like down low. Loses control. Parsons will maintain possession here. The foul call, that's on Jay-Z, and that's going to be his first of the night. Okay, here we go. Parsons back on offense. Oh, pass. Great interception there by Yogi. He gets it immediately to Jace. He turns right around and gives it to Trey. All right, Trey's got the ball. 20 seconds to go. This will probably be the last possession of the first half. 16 seconds. 15. Countdown is on here. Trey doesn't seem like he's in too big of a hurry. He obviously doesn't want to give Parsons a chance to score three here. They want to take the last basket. 4, 3, 2. No good. Shot up. No good. Clock's going to stop at 2.2 seconds to go in the half, and it looks like we're setting up for some free throws here. Looks like we're setting up for some free throws. Trey Carter is going to shoot two free throws here. Once again, he shoots 60.5% on the year. All right, that is number two. That is Travion Mack. And that is his second of the night. First free throw up and good. 28. Phoenix with a chance to go up by tanking here right before half. All right, 2.2 seconds to go. Trey Carter at the line, getting ready to shoot his second free throw here. Free throw up. Good. Phoenix up by 10. 2.2 to go. All right, They're going to set this up, and, you know, they're going to try and go quick. They're going to try and get a long pass in and get a shot up. Yogi got it. Up. Oh, no good. Oh, that one was close, but he picked that ball right off. All right. So, going into halftime here. Phoenix have to be happy with where we're at. Okay? Phoenix has to be happy with where we're at. They're up by 10. Obviously, the Phoenix are going to want to extend this lead coming out of halftime. So we'll see what happens when we come back. Okay, we have 10 minutes on the clock for the half. I'll try and get back here to 2 minutes. I'm going to run and get the points for Coach from Coach Harris, and he's going to give those to me, and I'll give those to you when we come back. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
We are coming up on a minute to go right before halftime ends, okay? Your score here so far, 29-19 in favor of the Phoenix. All right, so I went and got the stats from Coach Harris, okay? So far, we have a pretty even distribution around, you know, who's scoring points. So your leading scorer tonight for the Phoenix is Zamar. He's got 7. He does have 2 fouls. Trey has 6 points tonight. Yogi Purdy with 5. Jace with 4, Eric with 2 and 3 fouls. Jeter's got 1, and Jay-Z has 4 points for a grand total of 29. So when we're looking at what we want, so coming off of, let's take a look at Parsons real quick with 15 seconds to go. Keel has 6, Sawyer has 4, Quirin has 3, Tullis has 2, and Kendrick has 2 points for a grand total of 19 for Parsons. So coming out of half, here we go. Phoenix do get the ball coming out of half. All right. Trey's got it. Long pass to Jeter. Jeter, oh, about lost it. Oh, tried to get it back to Jace, or Trey, as he was going out of bounds. Couldn't quite get there. And Parsons back on offense quickly. Zamar's down there playing defense. Looks like Parsons lost control of the ball and fumbled it out of bounds. All right, Zamar got it to Trey. Trey back on offense. So each team with possession, no points scored so far. About poked that out. Trey to Zamar. Okay, starting 5 back on the floor. Zamar from the free throw line up and good. That is 2 more points for Zamar. 31-19 is the score. All right, Parsons back on offense, trying to get something going here. Trying to get something going. They're going to run around outside, take a long 3. No good. Rebound, Trey Carter. That was number 1, Jamario Kendrick with the 3-point attempt. No good. Jeter, oh, pass was tipped there on the way to Jeter, but it's going to stay with the Phoenix because it was out of bounds right off the hand of a Parsons Viking. All right, Trey down there at the baseline trying to get the offense set up. 7-11 to go in the third quarter. 2 quarters stand between the Phoenix and another trip to the state title or the state tournament. Jeter's got it. He's going to take a jump shot from the free throw line. No good. Rebound, Vikings. Vikings quickly back on offense. This is what we were expecting, folks, is this back and forth, really, really quick stuff. All right, Parsons on offense, trying to get something going, trying to find a crack in that defense. Phoenix up by 12. Defense by Jeter. Shot up. No good. Ball's rolling around the court, and it is going to go out of bounds at the other end of the court. Off of the hand or off of the foot of probably a Phoenix as they're pointing towards the Vikings. So, Vikings ball back on offense. Parsons trying to move around. Trey lost his footing there, laying in it, a layup. Easy points there for the Vikings. Quickly back on offense. Zamar's got it. He gets it over to Trey. Trey is going to look, kick it down low to Eric. Eric's got it, going to go towards the basket, put up a shot, and good. 2 more for the Phoenix, 33-21 is the score. 6:15 to go in the third quarter. Parsons back on offense. Outside the three-point line, going to drive. Thought about a shot, decided against it. Down there against 6'4", Jeter, probably not the best decision. Jeter's going to try and block it. He gets a hand on it, but it's rebounded by the Vikings. Vikings ball, still have it. Trying to move around, trying to find something. All the way at the other end of the court. 3-point shot, no good. Rebound. Oh, we're going to have a foul called on the Vikings. Atchison possession. Atchison will maintain possession of the ball. All right, 21. Okay, that is Travion Tullis, and that is his fourth of the night. That is his fourth of the night. He is, I would say... And once again, the people who have listened last year and this year know I don't know a whole lot about basketball, but I'm going to say that he is in foul trouble. I'm going to make that declaration right now. Let's thank our sponsors real quick for all that they do for us. Okay, we're going to thank Cornerstone Printing and Daylight Donuts for sponsoring our broadcast and live streams.
Delicious place to go get donuts. They have donuts, sausage rolls, biscuits and gravy, iced coffee, regular coffee. In addition to all the traditional things you would find at a donut store, Cornerstone Printing, they are the, you know, I think, I don't know, I'm sure somebody does it, but I don't know of anybody that's not gotten their t-shirts through Sadie this year down there at Cornerstone. She does a great job for us, and we're super, super grateful for everything that they do for supporting our broadcasts and live streams. For those of you who don't know, we also broadcast the news every day. News airs at about 11 o'clock every day, so you can tune into that. That is live on Rainbow and YouTube. All right, coming out of this timeout, 33-21 is the score in favor of the Phoenix. Phoenix will have the ball here. 5:43 to go in the third quarter. All right, Zamar's got it. He gets it to Trey, and Trey's going to take it up the court. Moving from right to left. Crosses the Atchison baseline. Their basket is right in front of the Atchison bench right now. Oh, ball is stolen by the Vikings. They're going to put up a shot. No, they're going to lose it, and they're going to call tripping. They're going to call tripping probably on Zamar, judging by his reaction. And that is going to be Zamar's third of the night. That was defense there. Defense first there by the Phoenix. Okay, quickly, Vikings ball. They get it in, take a three-point shot, rebounded, no good, rebounded by the Phoenix. Zamar's got it on offense. He gets it down low to Eric. Eric's going to put it up. Good! Didn't count. 33-21, still your score. 5:15 to go. 5:10 to go. All right. Vikings on offense. Got it down low, kicked it outside, moving it around, trying to find the hot hand here. Oh, blocked by Trey, right back into the face of the Parsons Viking there. Jeter's right there on defense. Down low. Ball was last touched by the Vikings. It went right out of bounds, so that is going to be Atchison Phoenix ball. All right, Trey's going to inbounds it to Jay-Z. 4:49 to go. 33-21. Bit of defensive struggle this second half so far. All right. Trey on offense. Long pass over to Zamar. Zamar's pass. Tried to get back to Trey. And it was batted by the Vikings. And Zamar tried to catch it. And then it went out of bounds off the hand of the Zamar. And so it's going to be Vikings ball. Another possession that the Phoenix have on offense with it coming up empty. Hopefully the Vikings will come up empty on this possession as well. All right. Vikings on offense. Screen there. Long three for the Vikings. Shot up. No good. Rebounded by Zamar Hernandez. He's got it. He's going to throw a long pass down to Jeter. Jeter's going to get it down to Jay-Z. Jay-Z's going to put up a shot. Good! Two more for the Phoenix. 35-21 is the score. Vikings quickly back on offense. Inside the three-point line. Now back outside. Going to drive the basket. Kick it out. Three, thought about a three, decided against it. Ball loose, picked up by the Phoenix and Jeter Purdy, and it's going to go out of bounds on somebody. Looks like it was off the hand of Jeter Purdy. Parsons will maintain possession. Inbounds the ball here. Parsons has it on offense. Moving it around, right around the free throw line, back outside the three-point line. Screen there. Backing up. Going to drive. Kicked it out wide. Going to drive in again. Kicked it back out wide. Three-point shot up. No good. Rebound, Jeter Purdy. He's got it. They're trying to trap him down there. He's got to get it out, and he gets it over to Eric, who gets it over to Trey. Trey's got it. He's going to drive. What's he going to do? He's going to turn around, jump shot. No good. Short. Rebound, Parsons, Vikings. Back on offense is the Vikings. Less than 3.5 to go in the third quarter. 21-35 is the score here in this sub-state championship game. Shot up. Good for the Vikings. That's a three. 24-35 is the score now. 3:15 to go. Phoenix back on offense. Hopefully they can get reset here and kind of get their composure back. Been a lot of fast breaks here. Long pass over to Jay-Z. Back up to Zamar. Back over to Trey. Trey down low to Eric. Eric to Jeter. Jeter up. Good. Parsons on offense here. 37-24 is the score. Quickly going to work. Thought about a three, decided against it. Going to drive to the basket. Kicked it out wide. Long three up, no good. Rebound, Jeter Purdy. Jeter's got it. He gets it to Trey. Trey's going to go quick. Long pass to Zamar. Zamar down to Eric. Eric about lost it, but he maintained control. Puts up a shot. No good. Rebound, Vikings. All right, we're down to two. Less than 2.5 to go in the third quarter. Been a quick quarter. Oh, looked like he got lost down there. Okay, 37-26. Phoenix up by 11 here. Zamar on offense. Over to Trey. Back to Zamar. Zamar, long pass to Jay-Z, right back to Trey immediately. All right, set the play and go. Over to Jay-Z. Suffocating defense there by the Vikings. You can see here that the Phoenix have decided that they're going to slow it down. They're going to slow down the game, and they're going to try to play possession. Bounce pass to Jeter. Jeter puts it up, and good. Two more points for the Phoenix. 39-26 is the score here. Phoenix up by 13. Phoenix up by 13. All smiles right now. All smiles right now. We do have a timeout called on the court. That's a 30-second timeout. I would imagine that was called by Parsons. In that last possession there, you could really see that Atchison was trying, it seems like, and maybe this is just what it seems, and things are not always as they seem, but it seemed like Atchison was trying to slow it down a little bit, and maybe try to play a little possession basketball. Don't give the Vikings so many opportunities, and don't let them get so many fast break opportunities. So, coming out of this timeout, we'll see what the plan is on offense for the Phoenix and defense. It does appear that the Vikings will be maintaining control here. They will have possession of the ball. And down they go to the baseline. Atch is going to play a little bit of that full court pressure that they have. Okay, we haven't seen a full court press yet, but we are seeing some pressure. We are seeing some pressure. Just making them a little bit uncomfortable. Vikings back on offense. All right, shot's going to be up by the Vikings, and that one sinks right in. That was quick points. 30, cut the lead to 11 here. 1.5 to go in the third quarter. All right, Trey's got it. He's going to kick it out to Zamar. Zamar's got it. Once again, going to set that offense up. Kick it over to Jay-Z. Jay-Z over to Trey. Good move by Trey. Has it. He's back outside the three-point line. Looks like they're trying to trap him down there. Jeter's got it. Puts up a shot. Good! Two more points for Jeter Purdy. 41-28 to score. Less than a minute to go now in the third quarter. We do have a stoppage play. Looks like there is going to be a foul call. You see the official going over to the table here. All right, that is on number two. That is Jeter. That is his first foul of the night. Parsons will still have possession of the ball. All right, Parsons has it. Oh, Jay's trying to check in, and they told him not to check in. All right, here we go. Parsons on offense, slaps the ball. Probably set the offense in motion. I don't know why he slapped the ball. Outside the three. Oh, ball's on the ground. Long pass over to Jeter. Jeter's got it. He's going to lay it in for an easy two more points. All right, here we go. Phoenix still on defense, playing that full court pressure they've got. Trying to get back. Parsons sets up the offense. 43-28 to score. Parsons shot up, no good. Rebounded Eric Smith. He gets it over to Trey, and Trey's going to take it up the court, moving from right to left. He's got it, and once again, looks like they're trying to slow it down here. We've got less than 20 seconds to go in the third quarter. You have to imagine that the Phoenix want to have the last possession here, and they want to have the last opportunity in the third quarter to score a few more points. Over to Jeter. Jeter's going to take a three with 7.3 to go. They're not going to count it, even though he made it. What are we going to call? We're going to have a foul called on somebody. Looks like it's going to be on the Vikings, and that is going to be Jamario Kendrick. That is his first foul of the night. All right, Phoenix with control here, with possession of the ball. 7.3 seconds to go in the third quarter. Jace has checked in. He looks like Eric came out of the game. Jace going to drive, put up a shot. No good. Rebound, Vikings. One less than a second to go. They take a full court shot off the front of the rim. Boy, that one was close. All right, so 8 minutes. 8 minutes, folks. That's all that stands in the way between the Phoenix and another trip to the state tournament in Salina. That's all that we've got. All right, 43-28 is the score. Real quick, while we're in this quarter break, we are going to thank our sponsors, Cornerstone Printing and Daylight Donuts, for sponsoring our broadcasts and live streams and all that they do to support our students in the video production classes and our student athletes, because without them, we wouldn't be able to bring this to you free of charge on Rainbow and YouTube. So we're very appreciative of them and all that they do to support us. So thank you to them once again. All right, so like I said, 8 minutes is all we've got left. All right, out come everybody, off go the cheerleaders, student section stands right back up. Parsons is gonna have the ball here to start the fourth quarter. 43-28 with 8 to go. All right, Parsons with the ball. Moving, moving, moving. Oh, Jay-Z about got a hand. He did get a hand on that. So DeMar's got it. He ends up poking it out. Long pass to Jay-Z. Jay-Z's going to lay it in. And two more points. 45-28 is the score now. We are less than a minute into the fourth quarter, and we already have a Phoenix basket off a defensive stop. Ball lost control. Tried to throw it back in. Got it to Jeter. Jeter got to Trey. Trey to DeMar. DeMar lost control. And he tried to throw it back in, but Parsons does recover that. That's a good defensive play there by the Vikings. All right, we are going to have a stoppage play. Looks like a foul. Somebody probably reached in there. All right, and that is going to be on number 3. That is Trey. That is his first of the night. Now, he did get in some foul trouble on Wednesday, but he has maintained possession or maintained control here very well and not gotten into any foul trouble. And you have to appreciate that. Shot up, no good for the Vikings. Back on offense of the Phoenix. Jeter's got it after a long pass from Trey Carter. He kicks it out to Jay-Z. Jay-Z puts up a 3. No good. Rebounded by Jace. Puts it right back. 2 more points for the Phoenix. 47-28 is their score. Phoenix now up by 19. You can see them starting to impose their will a little bit. You know, got down early. Came back. Long 3 from Parsons. Up, no good. Rebounded by the Vikings. Good defense there by Jace Richards. Getting a little bit of aggressive. And we're going to have another stoppage of play here. And you can see the Atchison bench getting excited. You can see the Atchison bench getting excited. 6:46 to go in this ball game. Atchison with the ball here. Trey Carter going to inbounds it to Zamar. Couple check in for the Vikings. All right, Trey's got it. He gets it to Zamar. Zamar's going to set up the offense here. What do we want? Gets it over to Jeter. Jeter down to Trey. Trey's going to lay it in. Good! 2 more points! 49-28 is the score now. Phoenix now have a lead of 21. Phoenix now have a lead of 21. Parsons quickly back on offense. Ball is knocked out by Trey off the hand of the or off the leg of the Viking. You can see the official tap his leg, so that is going to be Phoenix ball. Folks, we ask you to stay with us after the game while we have a trophy presentation. The Substate Championship trophy will be presented to the winning school after the end of this game. All right. Phoenix back on offense. Zamar to Trey. Trey to Zamar. Zamar's got it. Parsons trying to add a little bit of pressure here. Getting a little physical there with Jeter. He gets it over to Trey. Trey's got it. He's going to make a move to the basket. He's going to get it to Jace. Jace's going to put it up. Oh, and he just missed that, just barely. Wow, that was close. But Zamar's going to poke that out, and he's got nobody down there. He's going to put in an easy layup for 2 points. 51-28 is the score now. Once again, you can see the Phoenix imposing their will here in the later parts of this game. 3-point shot up for the Vikings. Up, no good. Rebounded Jeter Purdy. Jeter over to Trey. Looks like Eric is waiting to check in the ball game here. All right, Zamar's got it. He's going to try and set something up here. You got to imagine they're going to be trying to slow it down now. Up 51-28. Trey's going to drive, put up a shot. Good! Two more points. 53-28. 5:16 to go in this ball game. Atchison going on a little bit of a run here. All right, out comes Jace, in comes Eric. Out comes Jace, in comes Eric. Parsons ready to get the ball to start this possession. All right, on the floor for the Phoenix, we have number three, Trey Carter. Number two, Jeter Purdy. We're also going to have, once everybody gets in frame here, I'll tell you. We'll say number 10, J.C. Kelly. Number 0, Zamar Hernandez. And number 23, Eric Smith III. Shot up for the Vikings. Up, and that one is good. Jeter inbounds to Trey. Trey's going to go, and you see the Parsons is trying to add a little bit of pressure to this Phoenix offense here, but Trey's going to drive right to the basket, kick it out to Jay-Z. Jay-Z's going to take a three. He's going to miss it, but it's going to be rebounded by Eric, who's going to put it back for two more points. 55-30 is your score. Atchison now leads by 25. They were down early in the first, folks, and you can see them. Oh, that was a great defensive move by Eric. He lost the ball, got his hands on that, and he's going to give it right back to Trey as we go back on offense here. Less than 4.5 to go. Jeter takes a three. Shot up. Good. Sinks it. 3 points. 58-30. Atchison now up by 28. Timeout called by the Vikings, I'm going to assume. What a second half by the Phoenix. This is a phenomenal second half that they've played here. Folks, once again, we ask you to stay with us after the game where the trophy will be presented to the winning school. And along with our trophy comes a ticket to the state tournament that will take place in Salina next week at the, I believe it's now called the Tony's Pizza Event Center. I know it is the Bicentennial Center. All right, so out come the cheerleaders. They're coached by Miss Brittany Schultz. And we've got a herd of cheerleaders this year, folks. All right, real quick, while we have 30 seconds, let's thank our sponsors one more time. We're going to thank Cornerstone Printing and Daylight Donuts for sponsoring our broadcasts and live streams. That includes almost all home events. Okay, we will have baseball action coming at you here after the end of basketball season. And we do broadcast the news every day. That goes live on Rainbow and YouTube at about 11 o'clock. All right, so 4:23 to go in this sub-state championship game with a ticket to state on the line. 58-30 is your score here. Phoenix lead by 28. All right, here we go. Parsons on offense here. They're going to try and probably go quickly here. But hopefully they want to try and stop the bleeding here, but they're going to lose the ball. Zamar's got it. He's going to throw up a layup, and he's got it. Good. Parsons now losing by 30. Phoenix up by 30 in this sub-state title game. Ball off the hands of the Vikings. Zamar's got it again. He's going to set up a three. Long three. No good. Rebounded by the Vikings. Long pass over. Defense by Jeter. Couldn't quite get there. So Parsons now two more points for the Vikings. 3:40 to go in this ball game. Once again, Parsons trying to add a little bit of pressure there to the Phoenix offense. Trey's got it. He's going to put up a shot. And good! Phoenix once again lead by 30. Long three for the Vikings. Up off the front of the rim. Rebounded by the Vikings there. Jay-Z had a hand on it. Couldn't quite get the wrangle there. But they lay in a two-point shot, and that is going to go. All right, Phoenix back on offense, back to work here. Coming up on three to go in this contest. Looking to punch a ticket to state for the second year in a row. That's going to be out of bounds, off the hand of probably. I think they were trying to give it to Yogi. Yogi is in the game here. I missed that. All right. So that's going to be Parsons' ball. Phoenix getting back on D. All right, on the floor, you have number three, Trey Carter. Number 33, Yogi Purdy. Number 0, Zamar. Number 23, Eric. And number 10, Jay-Z. Yogi on defense there. Shot up by the Vikings is up and good. 36-62 is the score. From coming up on 2 minutes to go in this contest. Trey makes a great move up there. He's going to drive, lay in two, and he's going to get that two more points, 64-36. Atchison lead down to 28. Vikings on offense here. We're now under two to go. You can see Coach Battle getting ready to check in the young guys. Shot up by the Vikings, up, no good. Rebounded by Parsons. They're going to, oh, Yogi gets a hand on that over the top there, over the back of that Parsons Viking, and he pokes it out, and they're going to shoot free throws, it looks like. That is the second team foul on the Phoenix in this quarter, and that is Yogi Purdy. That is his second foul of the night. All right, Vikings going to the line. All right, out go the varsity starters, and in comes... I saw him first, number 20, Aiden Reban. Number 40, Aaron Friedel. That is number 22, that is Kale Williams. And looks like number 11 is Zydron Mays. And that was only four, so we'll get that last one here in just a second. And that is number one, that is Josiah Thompson. All right, here we go. Parsons free throws. That is a rebound by Kale Williams. He's going to get it over to Josiah Thompson. Josiah Thompson's got it, and he's going to set up the offense here. We are down to 30 seconds to go in this ball game. Kale's got it. He's going to lay up a shot. No good, but looks like he is going to be fouled. We do have a running clock here, folks. So we're talking 20 seconds away from Atchison punching their ticket to state once again, second year in a row. And you got to be so happy for these guys and these seniors, okay? Once again, we ask you to stick with us while we present the trophy to the winning school. And that is going to be, the winning school is going to be the Phoenix. That was Kale Williams. He was fouled there. He's at the line shooting free throws. And that is it. That is the ball game. 64-37, the final in this sub-state championship game from Atchison High School. You see them shaking hands. You see them shaking hands, and they're going to shake hands, and we're going to get the trophy presentation coming at you in just a second. What an exciting time. What an exciting time at the high school. You know, and you have to be happy going into this state tournament with how these guys are playing, how well they've gelled as a team, and how well that they've come together. This has been a sight to watch, and I've been so grateful to watch them throughout this year and, you know, be with them through the highs and through the lows. As you see there's some sub-state championship t-shirts coming at you, sub-state championship t-shirts coming at you. You see Trey Carter there, he's putting his on, and the crowd, I can't hear the crowd back where I'm at, but I imagine the crowd is just raucous. Second year in a row that we've got sub-state championship t-shirts. I'm gonna take a guess. I bet those were made by Sadie Stone at Cornerstone Printing. You see them getting their sub-state t-shirts on. Phenomenal. This is so exciting. Thank you to our sponsors one more time, Cornerstone Printing and Daylight Donuts, for sponsoring our broadcast and live. So you see our athletic director there, off on the right side of your screen, looking ready to hand the trophy off. You see hugs going around. You see everybody's just so excited. I can't wait to get down there to congratulate those guys. I'm so happy for them. It's just such a great group of individuals, such a great group of guys, great group of coaches, the players, everybody, top to bottom. This has been a total team effort. And here we go. There's your trophy presentation. Handed to senior Jeter Purdy. He's going to hold it up in the air. That's phenomenal. I'm so happy for these guys. What a time. What a time. This is great. I'm just so happy for these guys. They played a great game. And out come the students. Here they come. They're involved. They're ready to roll. I'm so happy for these guys. So, wrapping this up here. I have no doubt that Mr. Lukanoff, as soon as we have the state brackets, I have no idea when those are going to come out, but they will be posted to all of our social medias, and you will be able to see when the Phoenix will be playing. Last year, they played the late game.
we'll see. They reseed everybody out. How it works in basketball is they reseed everybody out based on record. So from my assumptions, based on my assumptions, if everybody wins who is, quote, supposed to win, okay, your Phoenix will probably be, we'll see. It's going to be between Hugoton High School down there in Southwest Kansas and the Phoenix for the three, for the two seeds. Okay, if the Phoenix aren't the two, they'll be the three. Okay, and this is the top eight. Top eight is who is going. There's four from the East and four from the West. So we'll see. We'll see what happens. We'll see what happens. And this is an exciting time to be an Atchison High School alumni, to be an Atchison High School teacher, and to be involved with these guys. So we want to thank you for spending your Saturday evening with us. It's still early. It's only 6:17. It's still early. Still have time to go out town and get some food, hang out, enjoy the evening. Thank you for taking your Saturday to spend with us. And if the director, Caden, if you have nothing else for me, we are good. Thank you so much for joining us. Have a great night.